بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In a previous video, we obtained those integrals x from 0 to 1 log x squared log 1 plus or minus x divided by 1 plus or minus x, and also this integral which has a minus sign in the numerator and in the denominator, but it stops here at 1 half. The goal now is to use these results and evaluate those integrals. The first two of them are straightforward and can be obtained from the previous results using one step of integration by parts. If we are interested in the integral x from 0 to 1 log x log 1 plus x squared over x, we can write down this integral as integral x from 0 to 1 log 1 plus x squared d 1 half log x squared. We do integration by parts. As x tends to 0 from above or to 1 from below, the product of these two functions of x tends to 0. In this video, all the limits that disappear are equal to 0, and they can be obtained either directly or by applying L'Hopital's rule. Our integral is minus integral x from 0 to 1 1 half log x squared times the derivative of this function of x, which is 2 log 1 plus x over 1 plus x. Thus, the value of this integral here is the negative of this integral. If our interest is the integral x from 0 to 1, log x log 1 plus x log 1 minus x over x, we start with the same step. This integral is minus integral x from 0 to 1, 1 half log x squared. We need to multiply by the derivative of this product with respect to x. We have two terms, log 1 minus x over 1 plus x minus log 1 plus x over 1 minus x. Those are old friends. Now let's do something more sophisticated. Integral x from 0 to 1 log 1 plus x over 1 plus x times the square of log 1 minus x. Replace x by 1 minus x. Log 1 minus x squared becomes log x squared. 1 plus x becomes 1 plus 1 minus x. That's 2 minus x. Write this logarithm as log 2 plus log 1 minus x over 2. Split into two integrals. Here is the first one. After rewriting the denominator as 2 times 1 minus x over 2, in this other integral, we do the change of variables y equal to x over 2. When x is 0, y is 0. When x is 1, y is equal to 1 half. Dx is 2 dy. 2 minus x is 2 minus 2y. So this part here is dy over 1 minus y. Log 1 minus x over 2 becomes log 1 minus y. Log x squared becomes log 2y squared, which is the square of log 2 plus log y. If we go back here, write 1 over 1 minus x over 2 as summation over non-negative integer j of x over 2 to the power j. If we integrate term by term, we have integral x from 0 to 1 x to the j times log x squared. For a and b with real parts greater than minus 1, integral x from 0 to 1 x to the a log x to the power b dx is equal to minus 1 to the power b gamma of b plus 1 divided by a plus 1 to the power b plus 1. So this integral here is minus 1 squared, which is 1, gamma of 3, which is 2. Downstairs, we have j plus 1 cubed. This part here is equal to 2 log 2, integral j from 0 to infinity, 1 half to the j plus 1, divided by j plus 1 cubed. Recall that the trilogarithm of z is summation j from 1 to infinity, z to the j, divided by j cubed. This means that this summation is the trilogarithm of 1 half. Let's now go to the integral from 0 to 1 half. Note that we have the square of log 2y, which is log y squared plus log 2 squared plus 2 log 2 log y. So this is log y squared plus log 2 as a common factor. Between brackets, we have log 2 plus 2 log y. This is log 2 plus log y squared, which is log 2y squared. We split this integral into two integrals. In one of them, we have log y squared. In the other, we have log 2y squared. The value of this integral is a previous result. Rewrite this integral as minus log 2 over 2 integral y from 0 to 1 half log 2y squared d log 1 minus y squared. The product of these two functions of y, as y tends to 0 from above, is 0. This is what we get when we use the upper limit of integration. We also have plus log 2 over 2 integral y from 0 to 1 half log 1 minus y squared multiplied by the derivative of this function with respect to y. This is 2 over y. This part is equal to 1 half times log 2 to the power 4. That part is log 2 integral y from 0 to 1 half log 1 minus y squared divided by y. In this integral, replace y by 1 minus y. We get integral y from 1 half to 1 log y squared over 1 minus y. This can be written as the integral from 0 to 1 minus the integral from 0 to 1 half. Both integrals are solved by writing 1 over 1 minus y as summation j from 0 to infinity y to the power j. Afterwards, we integrate term by term. When we integrate from 0 to 1, we get minus 1 cubed times gamma of 3 divided by j plus 1 cubed. We also have this minus sign here. So we have 2 summation j from 0 to infinity 1 over j plus 1 cubed. That's zeta of 3. We have another integral that looks like this one, but it is to 1 half For that integral, use the substitution y equal to v over 2. When y is 0, v is 0. When y is 1 half, v is 1. Y to the j becomes v to the j divided by 2 to the j. Log y squared becomes log v minus log 2 squared. We expand the square and split the integral into three integrals. In one of them, we have log v squared. In the second, we have log 2 squared. In the third, we have minus 2 log 2 times log v. We use this result here to evaluate those integrals. Minus this sum here is minus 2, the tri logarithm of 1 half, minus the sum over non-negative integer j of 1 half to the j plus 1 over j plus 1 is equal to log 1 minus half, that's log 1 half or minus log 2. When the sum is applied to this term, and because we have here 2, we get a term proportional to the di logarithm of 1 half, which is pi squared over 12 minus 1 half log 2 squared. When we put all the results together, the tri logarithm of 1 half disappears. Integral x from 0 to 1, log 1 plus x over 1 plus x, log 1 minus x squared, is given by this quantity here. The last integral we have is x from 0 to 1, log x over 1 plus x times the square of log 1 minus x. Replace x by 1 minus x, we get integral x from 0 to 1, log 1 minus x over 2 minus x log x squared. This integral can be written as integral from 0 to 1, log 1 minus x, d integral from 1 to x, log u squared over 2 minus u. The choice of this lower limit as 1 makes the product of these two functions of x tend to 0 as x tends to 1 from below. So when we do integration by parts, we get minus integral x from 0 to 1, integral u from 1 to x, log u squared over 2 minus u. We multiply by the derivative of log 1 minus x. We get plus 1 over 1 minus x. The integral with respect to u can be written as an integral from 0 to x minus an integral from 0 to 1. In the integral from 0 to 1, rename u as t. In the integral from 0 to x, do the change of variables u equal to xt. When u is 0, t is 0. When u is x, t is 1. The denominator becomes 2 minus xt. In the numerator, we get log xt squared. Note that we have here x divided by 1 minus x times 2 minus xt. Doing partial fractions, this is equal to 1 over 2 minus t times 1 minus x minus 2 over 2 minus t, 2 minus tx. We can take 1 over 2 minus t as a common factor. Then we have 1 over 1 minus x minus 2 over 2 minus tx. We take the product of log xt squared over 2 minus t and 2 over 2 minus tx as one integral. The other terms are combined in the integral here. In the numerator, we have the difference between log xt squared and log t squared. That's log x squared plus 2 log x log t. Split this into two integrals. In that one, use the change of variables z equal to xt. This integral is equal to the product of these two integrals. The first one of them is 2 zeta of 3. The second one is log 2. This double integral can also be written as the product of two integrals. The one with respect to x yields minus zeta of 2. To obtain the other one, take 2 as a common factor. We have 1 half integral t from 0 to 1 log t, 1 over 1 minus t over 2, which is summation j from 0 to infinity, 1 over 2 to the power j, t to the power j. Because of this 1 half, we have here 1 half to the j plus 1. We integrate term by term to get this sum, which is minus the di logarithm of 1 half. We have here 2 divided by t times 2 minus t, which can be written as 1 over t plus 1 over 2 minus t. This is the derivative with respect to t of log t minus log 2 minus t. We can integrate by parts. We have zeros when we use the limits of integration. In addition, we get minus integral t from 0 to 1, log t minus log 2 minus t, times the derivative of this integral with respect to t, which is this integrand with z replaced by t, log t squared divided by 2 minus t. We split into two integrals. This is the one on the second page. That one is evaluated in the standard way. We have log t cubed. We write the denominator as 2 times 1 minus t over 2, like what we did here. 1 over 1 minus t over 2 is this summation. We integrate term by term. Now we have the logarithm raised to the power 3. So our result is minus 1 to the power 3. That's minus 1. Then we have gamma of 4. That's 3 factorial or 6. Downstairs, we get j plus 1 to the power 4. This sum is minus 6 times the Pauli logarithm of order 4 with argument 1 half. The integral of interest, x from 0 to 1, log x, log 1 minus x squared over 1 plus x, is this result minus log 2 to the power 4 divided by 4 plus pi to the power 4 times 11 over 360. These are the five logarithmic integrals evaluated in this video.